Greetings and salutations. Today we have a brand new wear test from Fenty Beauty. I picked up two shades of their new We're Even Hydrating Longwear Concealer and I want to see how this goes. We're only wearing some brows and lash gel right now and we need to address this. Hello. I originally picked these up right before leaving on a flight to St. Lucia and I plan to take these on my carry-on and test some of the claims out in the water, in the humidity, but unfortunately I left them on my desk by accident and I was not the happiest camper at the airport because of that, because I felt like that was what I wanted to do for you all. But hopefully this is still exciting and informative in some way. Even though it may not have been the first one out, I appreciate anyone who is still watching and values my opinion. I picked up the shades 190W and 230W. The shade range is different on these, so I've reviewed basically every Fenty Beauty base product. You can check it out. I almost feel like I need to make a playlist or something, but if you just type in my screen name and Fenty Beauty, you should see plenty, or just search on my channel page. We've done it all and we're gonna wear a couple things today too. This is not what we want to see right now. Little backstory for those who don't follow me on Instagram. We did have our first pet loss in the family, so I'm in some sort of stage of grieving and that probably explains why this looks like this. And in similar notes, similar reasoning, I have a lot of dryness around the nose area right now. It's really flaky under the nose, so this little circumference, because aside from my normal texture there, I did a lot of wiping and screwed up my skin barrier. So we're trying our best. I haven't even moisturized yet today. That was too much. Those who've watched my pack with me, you've seen this shirt. If you haven't, I do a whole try on there. Did a Revolve haul. This concealer retails for $30 and I'll give you guys a glance at the shade range right now. It's a 12-hour hydrating longwear concealer with medium coverage and a natural second skin-like finish, something that sounds right up my alley. I will say I was quite confused about the shade range because Fenty has such a wide shade range that it's a good problem to have, but I feel like I can fit a lot of different shades, especially when it comes to the model photos. So I hope this is a good reference for all my shade twinsies. And if you haven't seen one of my videos before, I put all of my shade comparisons for concealers and foundations down below, things I've worn and tested and found to be the closest shade for me, if not the exact shade for me within different lines. And there's also a link to a longer list because I can't fit everything into the YouTube box. I wasn't the biggest fan of the other concealer releases and I have a very strong feeling this is going to be my favorite, so fingers crossed. So let's swatch the shades first together. This is shade 190W and I wanted that as my under eye shade. Please keep in mind that I am a little tan right now, but not summer tan. I have just a nice healthy flush of color from the sun. And this is 235W and I was hoping that would be somewhere near my skin tone shade. Typically I wear 240 in their foundations and I wear shade 4. We need to take a moment because I realize there's a discrepancy. Currently, my makeup drawer is in shambles because I was traveling and I just started tossing stuff. And usually this is where all my foundations are. My office is in shambles as well, so I'm keep this short. This is not my skin tint shade. The shade I'm wearing in this video is not my skin tint shade. This was sent via PR. I threw it into the slot. My number 9 is somewhere living its best life. And I didn't realize till I looked at my own shade reference list. I was like, I don't remember wearing shade 4. I wear shade 9, but that's in the summer. So I could probably, you know, go a little lighter. I'm sure I've said that in the reviews too, but this is a lot lighter and it still worked because, you know, she's Fenty and Fenty can do that. But I'm shade 9, what I usually am, but I am shade 240 in all the other foundations. And I'm that light, medium, medium for just about every other product within their line. And I use the shade Butter powder wise in the Loose Pro filter. Doesn't look too bad. I'm very curious to see what it looks like blended out. That 200s looked really similar. So this concealer claims to melt into your skin. It is evening brightening, but the formula claims to be super long wear. It's supposed to be crease fading sweat and humidity resistant, and it won't settle into fine lines or accentuate skin texture. Plus it's transfer and waterproof. The transfer and waterproof was what I was really trying to get at, but we will be spraying our face down at the end of the video. If you didn't know, that's what we do here. So let's get a thin layer of our Easy Drop shade 4 on our face. Still one of the best skin tints in the game. Brushing what's ever left on the brush on my eyelids just to cover up some of that redness and veining. Gosh, that under eye is glowing basically. Let's try the skin shade first. I can see that this is just a little lighter than me right now. You can tell by the corners of my forehead and such, but since we're gonna bronze those areas as well, I'm not too worried. But I do have this pimple right here. I just realized that you can't put this like this on your table, you have to lay it like this, which is fine. Totally fine, because it's not leaking out. I was like, why is it sliding away? Got a lot of redness under the chin, but I also have a lot of texture there. And then this acne scar and this acne scar, not the biggest fan of. The other sunspots, I guess I'm okay with. As you can see, this is warmer, but when you blend it out, it's not horrible. It's definitely warmer though. I would say this is closer to shade 5 probably, which I do not have right now. And if you think about that, if I'm shade 240 in foundations, 235 is a little bit more yellow and a little bit more dark. I was hesitant to go lighter in the shade that I wanted to use for my base and my scars because it's winter, it's January. If anything, I want to be able to use this throughout the year, so I aimed for that. But it's not bad. It's not horrible. I'm not like full glowing jaundice. As a jaundice baby myself, I do know what that looks like. We're okay. We're okay. Let's see what business Fenty's standing on. We should do this side, even though I would love a high contrast moment. I think I just went the wrong way with that one. So this is supposed to be for light to medium with warm undertones. It pretty much is that. It's sitting on the higher end of light, but it looks good as a highlight shade for us medium gals. Wow. I put a lot here by accident, so we're gonna bring it up here because I get really dark hollows, as you can see right there. With the brush, I feel like it's drying out a little fast, so I'm gonna take a sponge underneath and use a sponge for the other side as well. It is a thinner formulation than their previous concealer, the Pro Filter, but also the corrector is kind of similar in consistency. I would say this is just a little bit more hydrating. The corrector is really, really thin. What do you guys think? I do think a lot of the redness was canceled out, and we love to see it. It's good. I don't want to layer a coat immediately on there, so let's try the other side. Even though I have combo oily skin, I definitely lean hydrating formulas and setting them rather than matte formulas. So anytime Fenty releases something hydrating, I'm about it, and you'll find me talking about it. Fun facts, if you haven't seen my St. Lucia vlog, please check it out. I ended up trying out a new camera and I like it so much I rented it that I am gonna buy it today. So probably moving forward, there's a chance that there's a different close-up cam footage for my wear test. I think today we're gonna stick to the iPhone 15 because I really like to get into them lines when we're doing concealers. I like the under eye shade a lot. I think it's gonna be great year round. Back y'all up for a second. I wanted to stick to Fenty, but I don't think that's gonna give me what I'm looking for. So I'm going in with my Makeup by Mario medium skin enhancer, and then maybe we can set it with the Fenty powder. All the products I'm using will be in the info box. I'll have like one link, hopefully as minimal as possible, for you all to go shop all of it on one page if you would like anything. Would really love my F4 brush right now, but I don't have. Feel my face just sucking in all of the moisture from all the formulas because of all the travel and such. Now let's see if we have the ability to get Island Ting to work for us right now. I think this is more of my summer shade, so we're gonna carefully take a little bit at a time. It doesn't look bad. It looks pretty hydrated for the most part. How do we feel about that one layer? Do we think we should do a second? This is medium coverage and it's speaking medium coverage right now for sure. But if we wanna do a scientific test, we'll add just a small amount to each side, just right there, a focal point, blending it with a sponge so that's already gonna thin out just a little bit. Let it sit for a few seconds while I add a little bit of eyeshadow. I think, why not? Fenty's Shadow Stick in Tiramisu. It's technically Tiramisu. Basically my lid color, but better. The shade is matte too. I don't feel like it's building any more than what we have. It still looks just as good. That's pretty fresh. I don't really wanna set it. Take a peek at these fine lines. My Great Divide is sitting right there, but it's not breaking up on either Great Divides currently. See them? You see them? It looks good right now. It looks really good. I don't want to add much to anything because I feel like it probably doesn't need to be set. If I did set it, I'd use a very thin amount of our loose powder. Now, should we put a little bit of Inner Corner Pop? Yeah, why not? This is shade Sip and Sparkle. I'm putting whatever is on my brush from that just under my brow bone. Do a little gloss, a little Fenty Heat plumping moment. This is in Fenty Glow. I did not style my bangs today, so they're just kind of straight and floppy, but it's okay. This ain't bad, this ain't bad. So this is the distance shot. This is our up close shot. You can see every little baby hair, every little line. I'm gonna give you guys some close-up cam footage and a few starting point pictures, and hopefully see you guys at the end of thy day to see how this holds up and spray this baby down to see what the water does. It is 10:05 and we started our wear test around noon, so it's been 10 hours. I just reviewed our clips and photos. I didn't end up using my point and shoot for this video. I used just my phone, so let's put up our starting point picture and our current end of the day photo, as well as the footage for the starting of the day and the ending of the day. All the close-up little shot. I had to kind of review that to remember what it looked like. Overall, I do think we still have coverage under our eyes and in the spots. We concealed a little less on the cheek, I can see a little bit more pigmentation there, but under eyes is where I was primarily focusing. I do think I'm starting to look a little bit more tired here, not as bad as without. There's definitely some coverage still there and some correction still there, but I don't think I would say this looks super hydrated under my eyes right now. There's definitely a spot that wasn't caused by the concealer, but the concealer's accentuating it in the right corner of my eye. It looks, you know, just a little bit flaky, probably from whatever's going on in that corner, but not complaining, just saying. So about 4 to 5 hours into our test, my nose started to get oily. Like, I felt the oil starting to build up. And we didn't put a lot on our nose or anything like that, so I figured it'd be okay if I powdered just the nose. I didn't go to the under eyes at all or any other areas of the face. And I used the new peach shade. It's called Peach Pie from Huda Beauty. When they sent this over, I was like, okay, because I was using the Cherry Blossom Cake, which was pink. But the peach really hits different for my undertone. It's correcting. So I didn't have one of my fluffy puffs, so I just went like this with my sponge on the side of my nose. And as you can see, it kind of takes that shine away. That's all we did today. That was the only thing that happened. I did that earlier, and as you can see, the grease still came back because I didn't really do much there, and I do still get oily. I would like to reapply and see how it goes, but first, let's bring you guys in close. I do feel like there is natural texture being shown here, more so than my favorite concealer currently, which is the Makeup by Mario Surreal concealer. I feel like this is accentuating a little bit more than that, and I don't think it's winning the battle in the fine line category at all. So before we reapply, let's take a completely white cotton pad and let's tap it for just transfer reasonings, just tapping it onto the face. Nothing. Overall, not too bad. I wore all white, like a genius by accident. These butterfly clips are so cute. Back to 190W. And honestly, while we're here, the cream eyeshadow didn't do too bad because I have super oily lids, so I'm not surprised by the creasing at all after 10 hours. But it could be worse. It could be completely gone. It could be super shiny. So it's obviously very refreshed and very pretty, super brightening, and this is obviously more settled in. So let's give that a second and let's spray this side down. First, why is my hair look so puffy right now? Water time. I would consider that a test. I feel like we got a lot of the under eye wet. This is kind of giving me a little bit of trypophobia because it's just sitting on there, but I'm gonna take a tissue, pat the face a little bit. Of course, my bronzer is gonna come off, but I'm gonna check what we look like under the concealer area. Now that it's fully dried, what do you guys think? Large contrast? I'm wondering if it being fresh affects its integrity, so let's spray that down. I do think it breaks it up a little bit, to be honest. Just a little bit. Like, it's not fully gone. You'll still look great getting out of the water, but it is gonna break up, and a lot of products would do this. There are a small group that wouldn't. So I would say there's definitely a difference. There's definitely like an integrity thing. I don't know, and I don't think I would bet on letting it air dry being any different. I wouldn't want the water to settle into certain spots, if you know what I mean. Like, it's on top of it, but if you let it sit there long enough, eventually it sinks through. So I would say it did okay on the test. I think it did better on the transfer proof than the water. Oh my god, you can see all the dryness I mentioned to you guys around my nose. It is crusty, musty, dehydration. Not counting that, of course. If I had to give this a grade just off first impression, I would give this a solid B. I have no problem with the shades particularly. Maybe a little different for the skin tone shade just currently, but it'll probably work a lot better as I get into summer. A lot going on under my eyes, so I'm in that more like small club of these concealers are it for me, and then there's like a larger club of these can still work, but you know, I gotta keep these factors in mind, and then there's a like absolutely no side, of course. If we reference my concealer tier list video, this is definitely A tier, but it's not S tier. So hopefully that makes a lot of sense for you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you guys so much for watching. This has been my first wear test in a while, so she's a little rusty, but she always has fun. If you're new here, feel free to subscribe using this button. It's free 99. I'm gonna put some recent uploads on the screen right now, as well as some of my travel vlogs and footage. So please go support and please go check out what I got going on all my socials, including this channel, for the new year. I hope you guys enjoy. Happy 15 years together if you've been here for whatever amount, and I will see you guys in a later video.